Okay, I'd like to learn today about the Churban Beit HaMikdash from a different angle. Normally, you learn the Churban, you see that the Gemara says that the Churban happened because of three different Averot. That's the first Churban. And second Churban is because of Sinat Chinam. That's how the Gemara points out in Yuma Daf Tet. The Gemara says over there that the three Averot that caused the Churban were Kilui Arayot, Shfichut Damim, and Avodah Zara. That's Churban Bayit Rishon. Churban Bayit Sheni happened because of Sinat Chinam. And as you all know, that when we're dealing with the Nevi'im, Nevi'im is before Churban Bayit Sheni. That was right at the Churban Bayit Rishon. And that is some of the Nevi'ei, Zam, and even the Nevi'ei Nechama, Yirmiyah, for instance, when he has a whole Sefer talking about prior to the Churban Bayit Rishon and while the Churban Rishon was happening, he's telling us exactly why the Churban is going to come. And one of the psukim that Yirmiyah brings over here is a pasuk that Chazal speak at Masechet Nedarim, and from here you learn something very, very interesting, and we'll see how it works. The pasuk goes the following way: Mi ha'ish hechacham ve'aven et zot. Who is the clever person who would be wise enough to understand? Ve'asher diber pi Hashem elav ve'agida. Who would be so smart, such a clever person, that would know what Hashem has said? And the question is that people are being asked right now, Al ma avda ha'aretz nitzta kamidbar mibli over. Why is it that the land was destroyed? What's the reason that Beit HaMikdash was destroyed? Why is it that the land of Israel was completely taken over and turned over and plowed and nothing was left out of that land? And this question was asked, says the Gemara, to the wise people, to the Chachamim, then to the Nevi'im, and to the Malachi Asharet. Why did it need to be asked so many people? Says the Gemara that the reason to ask all these people, because nobody knew how to answer. And this is how the Gemara says in Nedarim. Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Rav, Mai dichtiv mi ha'ish ha'chacham ve'aven et zot? What does it mean, this Gemara? And the Gemara says, who is the clever person that will understand this? Davar ze nishal lechachamim ve'lanevim ve'lemalachei asharet ve'lo pirshu. Which means, they went to the Chachamim to ask this question. Why was the destruction of Beit HaMikdash? Why was the land of Israel destroyed? Why is that? They went to all the rabbis, all the Talmidei Chachamim, all the greatest people, G'dolei Ador. Nobody had an answer for this question. Nobody knew. Everything is perfect. Everybody is on the best behavior. Everybody is doing exactly what they need to be doing. So why is the land destroyed? Nobody knows. So they took that question to an upper level, higher level. Who is that? Le Nevi'im. They went to ask the Nevi'im. Now the Nevi'im already speak to Hashem. So therefore, they might have some kind of answer that the Chachamim didn't have. Nevi'im can see behind the scenes what's happening. And when they went to the Nevi'im, they asked them, why was the land destroyed? Nobody knew the answer. So they went to a higher level. Who's that? Malachei Asharet. They went to the Malachei Asharet. Malachei Asharet already, they're not Nevi'im, they're Malachim. They know what's happening behind the curtains, Me'achorei HaPargod. They're in Shamayim, they know exactly what's going on. And they went to ask them, what is the reason of the destruction of Beit HaMikdash, the destruction of Yerushalayim, the killing, the massacres that's happening throughout the land? And again, they didn't know the answer. Ve'lo pirshu. Nobody knew the answer. Which is fascinating, that nobody knows the answer. Nobody knows the answer. So who might know the answer? Says the Gemara, ve'lo pirshu at shepirshu HaKadosh Baruch Hu be'atzmo. The only one that knew how to answer this question was HaKadosh Baruch Hu b'chvodo u'v'atzmo. It says over here in the Pasuk that The only one that knew how to answer, מאיש החכם ויבן את זאת, ואשר דיבר פי השם אליו, ויגידה על מה עבדה הארץ, it's only ויומר השם. That's the only one that knew how to answer this hard question. And he answers the following, על עוזבה מתורתי, אשר נתתי לפניהם, ולא שמעו בקולי, ולא הלכו בה. Hashem answers that they didn't follow my Torah. Now, the Gemara says that it means something a little bit different. Because if you explain it to be just the simple meaning that they didn't follow the Torah, they didn't keep the mitzvot, everybody should have known that. That's not a secret. Why nobody knew that? Rather, it means, says the Gemara, ויאמר השם על עוזבם את תורתי אשר נתתי לפניהם ולא שמעו בקולי ולא הלכו בה, היינו, what does it mean? The repetition of לא שמעו בקולי ולא הלכו בה, says the Gemara, it means שאין מברכים בתורה תחילה. They didn't say ברכת התורה. That's what it means. It means that people were on the best behavior, perfect. People were unbelievably perfect. Nobody could have found anything wrong in people's acts, in people's behaviors, in people's, the way they conduct themselves with their neighbors, the way they conduct themselves with other people, with the way they perform the mitzvot, everybody were perfect. So therefore, what is the reason for the Chorban Beit HaMikdash? It can't even be that they didn't learn Torah, because if they didn't learn Torah, why is it that nobody knew? It says in the Torah, Im bechukotai timasu, Rashi says over there that you would not learn Torah, you lo shelo yu amelim batorah. The result of that would be the destruction of everything you have. So people should have known that if you don't learn Torah, there would be such severe consequences. So what does it mean over here that lo shamu bekoli velo alchu ba shelomar she'en mevarchim batorah tchila? This is the big sin of the people, and this is the reason that Beit HaMikdash was destroyed. Now, we'll try to ask a few questions on this, because it's really hard to understand. The first question is, didn't we say that the Chorban HaBayit was because of three great Averot, the grave sins of Gilui HaRayot, Shfichut Damim, and Avodah Zarah? What does it mean nobody knew why was the land destroyed? How could that be? It was a simple understanding that everybody saw. And the Gemara says in Yuma that since they sinned openly, also the Galut time was also open, which means the people were not doing something in private. Everybody, when the people were sinning openly. Look at what the Gemara says. The Gemara says, Mikdash Rishon. They were doing things openly. Rishonim shenitgale avonam, nitgale kitzam. Which means the avon they were doing was in the open. This is how Rashi explains. Lo ayu mechasim pishehem. People were not trying to hide their sins. So if that's the case, everybody should have known. Gilui HaRayot, Shfichut Damim, and Avodah Zarah was all over. It was something that people could have known, people should have known, and the question didn't need to go even to the Chachamim, even more so to the Nevi'im, and definitely not to the Malachi HaSharet. So we need understanding of what's going on in those Pesukim and in that Gemara. Secondly, let me read you some things that the Pasuk says right before it's bringing that Pasuk. Before the Pasuk that the people didn't know what the sin was all about, we read some of those Pesukim, and the Pasuk says the following. Yirmiyah now is talking in the name of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, which means he's getting a nevuah, he's getting a prophecy. The way you get a prophecy is that Hashem is speaking, and Yirmiyah gives it over, the way he hears it, the way it's brought to him. And now he's speaking in the name of Hashem. And Hashem says the following. Mi itneni b'midbar melon orchim. Who will give me, says Hashem, a hotel in the desert for guests? What does that mean? Hashem says, I can't tolerate being anymore within the people. I can't be anymore in the city. I have to go somewhere far. So he's using a metaphor over here. Just like a person that goes out of town, he needs to sleep, he needs to be in a certain place. Usually you take a hotel. So Hashem is using the same words. Mi itneni bamidbar melon orchim. Who will give me in the desert a hotel for the guests? Ve'ezva et ami. And with that, I will leave my nation. What is the problem? Why does Hashem want to leave the nation? Elchami itam, why? Why should I leave them? Ki chulam menafim atzeret bogdim. The whole nation are conducting themselves immorally. It says over here, not few, not one, not two, not three. It's not a sin of the individual. Ki chulam menafim atzeret bogdim. Everybody's misbehaving. The whole nation. Kulam menafim atzeret bogdim. So therefore, Hashem says, I can't live with them anymore. If it would be an individual sinning, it would be just a few, I would take care of them, get rid of them. But now that it's the whole nation, I have to leave myself. I can't be anymore around them. So therefore, I need to go a different place. What else do Am Yisrael are doing? Vayadrechu et leshonam kashtam sheker. People are using their tongue as an arrow. Yadrechu et leshonam kashtam sheker. In order for what? In order to shoot the arrows and hurt other people. Vadrechu et leshonam kashtam sheker. Velo leemuna. They're not honest. They can't be believed. They can't be having any of emuna that one should have for his friend. Gavru ba'aretz ki mera'a el ra'a yatzau. People were going from one evil thing to another evil thing. V'oti lo yadu ne'um Hashem. Nobody knew about me. Nobody had yediat Hashem. Nobody cared about Hashem. Nobody bothered to learn about Hashem. Now when you learn Torah, learning Torah is about learning Hashem's ways. Over here, people weren't interested. Ki mera'a el ra'a yatzau. They went from one evil thing, one corruption to another. V'oti lo yadau ne'um Hashem. Nobody knew about me. So therefore, you see how people conducted themselves. Ish mere'ehu ishameru. Comes the pasuk and says, be careful from your friends. Take caution from your friends. Mere'ehu. Every person has to be careful when he's dealing with another Jew. Ve'al kol ach al tiftachu. Even when you're dealing with your brother, make sure you don't trust him. That's what Hashem says, which means nobody's allowed to trust his friend, said Hashem, which means these are your best friends. You have one of your best friends. The pasuk says, don't trust him because he's going to cheat you. He's going to manipulate you in business. He's going to hurt your business. He's going to take away what you have, and he's going to try to stab you in the back. That's what the pasuk says. Ish mere'ehu ishameru. Every person has to be careful from his friend. Ve'al kol ach al tiftachu. Nobody should trust his brother. Why? Ki kol ach akov yaakov ve'kol rea rachil yaloch. Interesting words. Not that some brothers will manipulate their brothers. Ki kol ach akov yaakov. Every brother can't be trusted because every brother is looking to hurt his brother. Ve'kol rea, and every friend, rachil ya'aloch. Every friend is talking behind your back, which means to share a secret with your best friend. Hashem says, be sure that every friend that you have will cheat on you, will go behind your back and say what you said, will try to hurt you with the information you just told him. Your private life that you just shared with him, he'll go and he'll try to hurt you with that. Ve'ish berehu yehatelu. Every person is laughing and ridicule and belittling his friend and tries to cheat his friend. Ve'emet lo yedaberu. Nobody speaks the truth. Limdu leshonam daber sheker ehevan nil'u. This is the kind of people that were in Bayit Rishon, right before Chorban Bayit Rishon. And therefore Hashem says, I need to leave the place. I can't live anymore amongst those people. I have to run out. I have to go out of the city into a hotel that I can have over there peace without seeing what I'm seeing over here. לכן כה אמר השם צבקות הנני צורפם ובחנתים כי אחסם מפני בת עמי. This is what the psukim say, that now I'm going to put them to the test. Now I'm going to punish them. And after that pasuk, על הערים אשא בכי, השם says, I'm crying on the mountains. ונהי ועל נאות מדבר קינה, כי ניצתו מבלי איש עובר. Nobody is going to pass through that land because the whole place will be destroyed. And not even a bird will be able to pass through. It could be complete destruction. ונתתי את ירושלים לגלים מאון תנים ואת הרי יהודה אתן שממה מבלי יושב. And the next pasuk right afterwards is the pasuk we started off with. And that is the ultimate question. מי האיש החכם ויבן את זאת ואשר דיבר פי השם אליו ויגיד על מה עבדה הארץ? The question comes to ask, why was the land destroyed? And I'm asking, what do you mean, why was the land destroyed? You just gave me a whole understanding from the beginning of the parasha, how terrible people are behaving, how terrible people are conducting themselves in every area, whether it's together in business, with their friends, with their family, with the community, and with Hashem. So why is the land destroyed? Why should the land not be destroyed? That should be the question. מי האיש החכם ויבן את זאת ואשר דיבר פי השם אליו ויגיד why the land was not destroyed? But the question is, על מה עבדה הארץ? Very puzzling. What do you mean על מה עבדה הארץ? Of course the land should have been destroyed. This is the way people are doing and going through their life. Of course, it can't continue like that. And together with that, that we said, that Chazal already told us, that they were sinning in the greatest sins of Gilui Arayot, Shfichut Damim, and Avodah Zarah, we need to understand what is really the question of Al Ma Avdah Haaretz. So this question really can be answered in a few different ways. One of the ways that we'll try to answer today is that we need to understand that sometimes a person could make a grave sin, he could do something terrible, he could do a crime, but he'll get an immunity, which means the country would protect him. Although he did something wrong, but for some reason, sometimes they have a reason to give him a new immunity and to make sure that he's not gonna be hurt in any way. And that is what's going on over here as well. Over here, we need to know that the Gemara in Sotah Kaf Aleph says that Torah is magna umatzla, which means there's something called mitzvot and something that's called limud haTorah. Mitzvot and averot are some things that Hashem put in the world that we should be busy with, and averot stay away with. And then there's another thing that Hashem created that's a totally different category, and that is called HaTorah HaKadosha. When Hashem created the Torah has many, many advantages. But there's also another advantage of the Torah, and that it's magna umatzla. It protects from any harm. Magna min hapuraniyot, Rashi says, magna min hayisurim. The Torah protects you from anything that could come your way, any harmful thing, any kind of damage that would come your way and try to hurt you. The Torah is a protection, is a shield from anything that would happen. So sometimes a person puts himself in a danger. Sometimes a person will go into a place he shouldn't go and do something that would naturally hurt him, but his shield, he puts a shield in front of him and nothing happens. And this is what the Torah is about. The Torah is protecting a person from the pur'anut, from the damage, from the hurt, from the pain, from the yisurim, suffering that the person might get, the Torah protects him from that. And this is what the Gemara says over there. Etzu darash Rabbi Menachem ben Yossi, ki ner mitzvah ve Torah or. The ner, the candle, mitzvah is compared to a candle, but the Torah is compared to light. Veder chayim tochachot musar. Says the Gemara, Tala katuv et mitzvah bener. The Torah is comparing mitzvah to to a candle, ve'et ha-Torah be'or. But the Torah is compared not to a small candle, to a strong flashing light. Et ha-mitzvah be'ner lomar lecha ma'ner, ena megina ela lefi sha'a. A candle, when you have a candle, it protects you just temporarily. It protects you just as long as the candle and the wax wasn't finished. Once the wax is done, you don't have any more light from that candle. Af mitzvah ena megina ela lefi sha'a. To that we can compare a mitzvah. A person that performs a mitzvah, it's a beautiful thing. He'll get a protection. How long? Temporarily. Whatever time that mitzvah can protect. So you can do a mitzvah and go out and somebody needs to hurt you, as long as it didn't run out, the battery of the mitzvah didn't run out, you still are protected. But there's something else, that the battery never runs out. And that is Torah. Et ha-Torah be'or, the Torah compares, limud ha-Torah, the learning of the Torah, the pasuk compares to a light. Ma'or magen le'olam, af Torah megina le'olam. The Torah protects a person forever and ever, which means, once you learn Torah, you get yourself a shield from anything bad that could come your way. It says the following, Bitalecha, bitalechecha tancheotcha, b'shochvecha tishmor alecha, v'akitzot ahit esichecha. Bitalechecha, when you're walking, the Torah will lead you. When a person needs to walk in business, for instance, you need to buy a good deal that you just found. You don't know, should I buy it, should I not buy it? You're not sure. You need to open a business. You're not sure, is that a good business to open or it's not a good business to open? If you learn the Torah, it will give you guidance. Bitalechacha tanche otcha. Beshochbecha, when you go to sleep, tishmor alecha. The Torah will protect you. You go to sleep. People go to sleep. You don't know who might come into the house. What will happen? When you learn Torah, you get protection. Tishmor alecha. V'akitzota hitesichecha. When you wake up, He will lead you and protect you and give you everything that you need. Says the Gemara, b'italechacha tancheotcha, ze ha'olam hazeh. It means really what the pasuk comes to teach you is that it's in this world. When you are learning Torah, it will guide you in this world. Anything you need to do in this world, the Torah will guide you. B'shochvecha tishmor alecha, Zo hamita. When a person dies, lo aleinu, the Torah protects him. There's a lot to be protected when a person dies. There's mazikim, there's onashim, all kind of bad things that's happening. The Torah protects. V'akitzot ha'it esichecha, ze la'atid lavo. When a person will rise in tchiyat ha'metim, the Torah will over there reward him as well. And that is what the Gemara says as a mashal, a parable. Mashal le'adam, there was a person that went out of the city, it was very dark. He went out and he lost his way. Me'alech be'ishon laila. It was very dark outside. Mityare min ha'kotzim, min ha'pechatim, u'michaya ra'a u'min ha'listim. Ve'no yodea be'ezeh derech me'alech. When you walk out and you get lost in the dark and you have nothing to guide you, you don't have light and you don't have signs and you don't have anything, you are lost over there and you're afraid from different things. You're afraid that maybe you're walking and there's a pit right in front of you that you can't see and you fall inside. You're afraid that maybe there's thorns that are right in front of you that as soon as you make another step, that will sting you. And also you're afraid of animals in a desert outside of the city. It could be that there's bad animals that will come to hurt you, that could come to attack you. And also, it was very common that they had robbers on the road. Robbers are very common on the road. By the way, that's the reason you make Tfilat HaDerech in such a way, that we should be protected from robbers, because whenever people came out of the city, it's not like today, that you have police and you have law, and you have protection from them, law and order. Rather, it used to be chaos. You went out of the city, you don't know where you're getting into. So there would be listim. You don't know where to go also. Because even if nobody hurts you, but you don't know the direction you need to go. Now, if you got a small candle, says the Gemara, you still you are a little bit better off. Why? Because right now you can be protected from any pit that's of coming your way, that any thorn that you didn't see before, now you can see with that candle. Candles can shine a little bit around you. Then you have something a little bit more than that. And that is, if let's say you got more than just a candle, but you got also light. Nizdamna lo avuka shel or, nitzal min hakotzim, min mapechatim. ועדיין מתיירא מחיה רעה וליסטים ואינו יודע באיזה דרך ילך. כיוון שעלה עמוד השחר, let's say a little bit of the light came up, and now the morning started rising, then you are a little bit more protected because no animals will come anymore in the day. No listim, thieves, are likely to come in the day. But you still don't know where to go until you came towards a place that you find your ways. And this is what the Torah is about. This is a parable to the Torah. Once a person learns Torah, he's completely protected. This is what's going on over here. What's going on over here, that the psukim come and say, you need to know, people were sinning terrible sins. They were doing all the averot in the Torah. But on the same token, at the same time, they were learning Torah. So when you learn Torah, you are completely protected. And the question is, why isn't it that they got the protection? Why the protection didn't come to them? Why is it that at the same time they were sinning, the Torah didn't do that shield that should have protected them? That is the question that the Pasuk is asking. The Pasuk wants to know, after all these terrible things, why was the land destroyed? Because they did learn Torah, and therefore they should have been protected. This is the way to understand this. And the answer that Hashem said is the following. Yes, they learned Torah, but the Torah that they were learning was not Torah Lishma. When you learn Torah, it's true that you are doing a good thing, but in order to get the protection of the Torah, you also have to do it Lishma. What does it mean Lishma? It means, and how would you know if a person learns Torah Lishma? You would know by the fact that the Torah is first with the Birkat HaTorah. Before you start learning, you give the honor to the Torah. You give the respect to the Torah. You say Birkat HaTorah, and then you come to learn Torah. When you learn Torah in such a way, you'll be protected from the Torah. That's what it says in those psukim. And the only one that knew that such a thing wasn't actually coming about, the Torah wasn't able to protect them just because of Birkat HaTorah was Hashem Yitbarach. Nobody else knew that. Nobody else knew that. Because when they went and they saw the people are learning Torah, how would they know that because of Birkat HaTorah, the protection didn't come to them? That was Hashem that came and revealed that to the people. And look what it says in the Bach. The Bach says, Nir'ah kavanato Yitbarach me'olam, Hashem's purpose in the world, when He created the world and He gave us the Torah, הייתה שנהיה עוסקים בתורה כדי שתתעצם נשמתנו בעצמות ורוחניות וקדושת מקור מוצא התורה. Why was Hashem created the world? In order that we should be able to come close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That was the whole creation for, as we're going to see soon in the Bach. And Hashem made it in such a way that once you learn Torah, you're going to come close to Hashem. And therefore, it would make our neshama, titatzem nishmatenu, our neshama will become greater. Titatzem nishmatenu beatzmut, veruchaniyut, vekdushat makor motza Torah. The greatness of the Torah would make our neshama greater. ולכן נתן הקדוש ברוך הוא תורת אמת לישראל במתנה, השם גאיר עם ישראל, a gift, תורת אמת, שלא תשתכח מאיתנו כדי שתתדבק נשמותינו וגופנו ברמח איברים ושסה גידים, ברמח מצוות עשה ושסה לא תעשה. The R in the Torah, רמח מצוות עשה ושסה לא תעשה. 248 מצוות עשה and 365 מצוות לא תעשה. כנגד איברים וגידים של האדם, which means our body needs to be connected to the mitzvot. Once you're connected to the mitzvot, you're connected to Hashem Yitbarach. When you're connected to Hashem Yitbarach, הנשמה expounds. it becomes greater. It becomes, as it says over here, titatzem nishmatenu be'atzmut v'rachaniyut. It becomes much bigger, then becomes much holier. V'kedushat mekor motzah Torah. And therefore, that is the reason Hashem gave the Torah. She'im ayu oskim b'Torah al hakavana hazu, if Am Yisrael were learning Torah with this intention to come close to Hashem, hayuhema merkava ve'echal l'shchinato yitbarach. Am Yisrael will be the chariot to Hashem, which means Hashem Shechina comes down to the world, and who will be the one that will be inviting Hashem? A guest come to your house, you need a place. A guest comes to town, you need a place to be. So the person that invites that guest, he's the Merkava to the guest. You need somebody that needs to ride, needs to go from point A to a point B. I have a big rabbi. Who's going to take him? The car that takes him. That's the chariot that takes him. You need always some keli to be able to be mechil, to hold the light inside the vessel. The Shekhinah is a very strong light. You need for that a keli, you need for that a utensil that's going to hold the chariot, that's going to hold the Shekhinah. What is that? That is Am Yisrael, that becomes over here the chariot, the Merkava to the Shekhinah. When the Shekhinah can come down, has the possible way to come down, Am Yisrael can lead the Shekhinah Kedosha. And this is the whole purpose that Hashem created the world, and this is the purpose that Hashem gave us the Torah. That the world should be to be Megaleh Kvod Shamayim, and Am Yisrael can do that by learning Torah Lishma. When you learn Torah Lishma, you connect with Hashem. What have happened in that generation? Said the Bach over here that what happened was something terrible. People were learning Torah, but they were learning Torah for the wrong purpose. It says in the Bach that the purpose they were learning Torah was for their own intention. Ata she'avru chok. They violated this law that we just spoke. She'lo asku b'Torah ki im letzorech hadvarim hagashmiim. People were learning Torah. Yes, they were learning Torah. But the purpose of the learning Torah was not to come close to Hashem and to be nidbak with the Shekhinah, but rather the purpose of learning Torah in that generation was letzorech dvarim gashmiim, for materialistic things. What does that mean? What could be materialistic by learning Torah? He explains lida hadinim letzorech masa umatan. In order to be able to know how to make business, you needed to learn Torah. The way it's explained is the following. You know that sometimes you get people that go to court, secular court, and in order to win a case in the secular court, they take a lawyer. Sometimes they take a religious lawyer, a lawyer that went to yeshivot. When he sees a certain case that comes to him, he can do one of two things. Either think himself or go into the Torah, sugiyot in the Gemara, sugiyot in the Ktzot, sugiyot in the Netivot HaMishpat, sugiyot in all the Achronim that teach you how to see that case and how to be able to get it to the bottom of what's going on, to be able to understand exactly what's behind every case that you're seeing, how to be able to digest it correctly, how to be able to break apart that sugiyah into small elements. Those that go into the Torah can do that very well. Those that learned in yeshivot can do that very well. So therefore, sometimes you have those kind of lawyers that are religious lawyers, and they would take that and go into the sugiyah and come out, and nobody can stand in front of them because they become very sharp in their head and in the understanding. And that is what they do in many places in Israel, that they have in the secular court over there some kind of cases, and they'll take a lawyer that's very knowledgeable in the Torah and able to go into the sugiyot of the Gemara and come out with a winning strategy. And therefore, over here, that's what's going on. Over here, says the Bach, the people learn Torah. But what was the purpose of learning Torah? Ata avru chok ze, שלא עסקו בתורה כי אם לצורך הדברים הגשמיים. They only learned it for the materialistic reasons. להנאתם, לדעת דינים, לצורך מסע ומתן. They wanted to know how to conduct business. Now, business could be in very many different ways. You want to make business with your friend. You want to oversmart him. You want to know how to be able to get more than you really need to. If you learn into the Gemara is machkimat peti. He would make somebody who's simple, who's petty, who's not too smart, he make him smart, machkimat peti. That's what they would do. Secondly, gam litgaot la'arot chokhmatam. They would do that also for a different reason. In order to be able to show off, in order to be able to be respected, in order that they are together with others, they'll be able to shoot all kind of knowledge that the other person doesn't know. That's called litgaot, in order to show and be mitgae. Litgaot ularaot chokhmatam, and to show their wisdom. Lo nitkavnu leitatzem uleitabek bekedushat veruchaniyut haTorah. What they didn't do is learn for the purpose of knowing Torah better, in order to become closer to Hashem, in order to make your neshama bigger. That wasn't the purpose. And mimele ze garam churban. That is what brought the churban. We're explaining it the following way today. We're explaining it that the churban have happened because of the great sins that Am Yisrael made. As the pasuk says over here, the pasuk says that מראה אל ראה יצאו אותי לא ידעו, ידריכו לשונם קשתם שקר, כולם מנעפים עצרת בוגדים, איש איש, מראהו ישמרו, על כל אח אל תפתחו, כי כל אח עקב יעקב וקוראה ירחי להלוך. That is the reason for the destruction, yes. But why didn't they get the shield? Because the shield of the Torah would come only if you learn Torah לשמה. It's very interesting that Chazal say the following. Chazal say that Reshaim ayu ela shetalu bitchonam bakadosh baruch hu. What does that mean? It's a very puzzling Gemara. These were wicked people, but they trusted Hashem that the destruction would not come, the Chorban would not come. Talu bitchonam bakadosh baruch hu. They had bitachon im Hashem. How could a wicked person that does every avera under the sun have bitachon im Hashem? What does that mean? But according to what we're explaining right now, it comes out very good, because these were bad people. They were doing all the averot of the Torah, but natnu bitchonam, they gave their bitachon, they were reassured because they were learning Torah. They were walking with a shield. When a person is walking with a shield, he feels that he's not going to be hurt, and that is what caused the Chorban, because they didn't do it lishma. If they were learning Torah lishma, they would be protected. And slowly, slowly, maybe they would come back to the right way. And this is actually something that you all know probably from the Kli Yakar. The Kli Yakar explains that where it says in the Pasuk, Vayikrevu yemei evel avi v'arga et Yaakov achi, Esav saying, I'm waiting for my father to die, And there will be Evel, we will be mourning my father Yitzchak, and then I will kill my brother Yaakov. And the Kli Yakar is asking, why does it say over here, Vayikrevu yemei Evel Avi, the days of the mourning would come? It should have said in the Pasuk that Yikrevu yemei Mot Avi, when my father would die. What does it make a difference if they're Evel Avi? Evel is not the main thing. Once the father dies, then I can kill Yaakov. The death of Yaakov, the death of Yitzchak would allow me now to take action. What does it have to do with Yemei Evel Avi? What does it have to do with the Avelut? Says the Kli Yakar that Kol Zman sheYaakov haya osek baTorah, Yaakov was a very big matmid, as you all know. Yaakov was sitting and learning all day. As the Torah says, it indicates that in few places, and Rashi says like that. So therefore, when Yaakov was learning Torah all day, he was actually protected by that Torah. Kol zman sheYaakov haya osek baTorah, haya barur leEsav sheyesh malach sheshomer umagen alav. There's a malach that protects a person that learns Torah. ואין אפשרות להזיק לאחיו יעקב. Nobody would be able to hurt יעקב. אך מרגע שיקרבו ימי אבלו של יצחק, as soon as the days of the אבלות of the mourning would come, שיעקב יהיה אבל, אבל אסור בלימוד התורה, ממילא יוכל להורגו. When אבל can't learn Torah, just like on תשעה באב, you can't learn Torah. So ממילא, when the time will come and יעקב will be אבל, as soon as that happens, he can't learn Torah, he doesn't have the protection. Doesn't have the protection, now I can kill him. You all know. את דוד המלך. Asked הקדוש ברוך הוא, when would I die? And Hashem said that he can't tell him. גזרה, I can't tell you when is your day that you will pass away from this world. Nobody knows the day that he will pass away. So yeah, דוד המלך asked הקדוש ברוך הוא, at least tell me which day in the week. Don't tell me which day, but the day of the week you could tell me. Hashem told him on Shabbat. Shabbat. So David HaMelech came up with a brilliant idea. David HaMelech knew that Malach HaMavet can't come close to him if he learns Torah. Once you learn Torah, you're protected. That's it. So now although the gzera of David HaMelech should have came, but David HaMelech tricked Malach HaMavet. He would learn all day Shabbat. That's it. All day we sit and learn. Once you learn, you can't in any way get hurt. Malach HaMavet didn't know what to do. He's waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. Nothing's happening. David HaMelech is protected. He can't come close. The light of the Torah is so strong. When you learn Torah, you are fully protected. Malach HaMavet has to stay far, far away from you. But he didn't know what to do, Malach HaMavet, because Hashem said, Gzera, today, that's it, time has come, it's today. Now Malach HaMavet has to do the messenger, the shlichut, of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Well, on the other hand, he can't come close to David HaMelech. What should he do? Then he decided, you know what? Let's try something new. He started making noise outside by the trees, and David HaMelech, for a split second, he wanted to see what happened. A hurricane outside? There's a change of weather? They didn't say anything in the broadcast. What happened? Looks out the window for a split second, and that is when the Malach HaMavet was able to reach out to David. We see that the Torah has that power that's called Magna Umatzla. Magna Umatzla, as long as a person is learning Torah, he's protected, but he's protected even if he doesn't deserve the protection, which means even if he's guilty, as they were in Bayit Rishon, in all these terrible averot, even if he's guilty that Hashem says, I can't live amongst the people anymore, even if the day that Malach HaMavet should come and take away his neshama and really shouldn't be anymore, he's still protected. With all that, he's protected. And Chazal say also that avera mechaba mitzvah ve'en avera mechaba sachar mishasak b'torah, which means if you are guilty of any avera, the problem with an avera is that besides all the terrible things, it's able to erase the mitzvot you make. You made a mitzvah yesterday, a great mitzvah. Today you're making a great avera. If it's an equal mitzvah to the avera, equal, it would erase one to the other. They would take in shamayim the avera and erase your mitzvah. But what can't erase anything is a person that learned Torah. En avera mechaba schar mi she'asak b'torah. If you learn Torah, you are protected. Even if avera came your way and you fell into it, the mitzvah of Torah, of learning Torah, is standing still out there to protect you. This is one way how to understand this. We go and explain it a second way. And that is, Chazal tell us the following. Chazal say that when a person learns Torah, it has to change the way you behave. It has to change the way you perform mitzvot. It says in the Yerushalmi, Alevai oti azvu v'etorati shamu. I wish that the Torah would be learned, even if the people leave me, says Hashem. Hashem says, I wish people would abandon me, but at least they would continue to learn Torah. Why? Shehamaor sheba machziram lamutav. When a person learns Torah, eventually he would start also coming close to the right way, coming close to Hashem's ways, which means you're right that a person could sin terrible sins. But if you tell a person that sinning, come and learn Torah, come with us to a Shiur Gemara, come once a week, twice a week, come every night for half an hour, 45 minutes to learn Torah, you'll see that the person slowly, slowly starting to change. It has magical powers unlike anything else. If you tell a person that doesn't keep Torah, start doing one mitzvah, do one mitzvah, not very likely he would go and start keeping the rest of the mitzvot. Maybe yes, maybe no. But if you tell him, come half an hour every night to learn with me Gemara, that's talking about something that has no relation to mitzvot. You're talking to him about Shor Shenagach Et HaPara. And you go into the Gemara in depth, you will see a change in no time with the person. Why? Because Ha'or Sheba, Ma'or Sheba, the light in the Torah is able to form a person, reform a person, change a person, and slowly, slowly, he comes close. And this is what's going on over here. The Chachamim asked over here a question. They didn't know why, not why was the land destroyed. That wasn't the question. The question they had was, how did the people came so low? How did the people become so terrible? How did the people become so corrupted? How did doing such terrible things? This is something you didn't see in previous generations. People wanted to know what happened to this generation. They went to the Chachamim and they asked them, why were people behaving so terribly? And they didn't know. They went to the Malachim and the Malachi Asharet and nobody knew. And only Hashem was able to tell the reason. The reason is because people were learning Torah. The Torah should have brought them to the right way. But that's only if you learn it with a good intention. But if you learn Torah with a bad intention, that's not going to lead you to the correct way. Now, there is such a thing that Chazal say in few places, that Le'olam ilmad adam Torah shelo lishma, shemitoch shelo lishma yavo lishma. Which means you should learn Torah even with a bad intention. But that is only when you have, at least in the back of your mind, that eventually I want to change my way, I want to improve. But if your whole purpose of doing things is in order to do for the wrong reasons, in order to get the wrong results, that is something that's not going to lead you step by step towards the right way of keeping Torah and mitzvot. This is the second way how to explain this. And the third way how to explain the question that they ask, why is it that Am Yisrael were going to Galut? Why is it that the Torah didn't protect them? The question was not why was Beit HaMikdash destroyed. That we can see from the Psukim. The Torah was destroyed because of those terrible sins that Am Yisrael have made. But the question over here was, Al ma avda aretz, which means, why was the land destroyed? Not Beit HaMikdash. Beit HaMikdash can't be while Am Yisrael are sinning. That is true. But at least when Beit HaMikdash is destroyed and Am Yisrael go to exile, why is it that the land of Israel has to be so deserted? That is the question, which means, in other words, not only that Hashem have left the land, not only that the people have left the land, but also Hashem left the land. Because if the land is so deserted, obviously Hashem is not there. Because if Hashem would be there, there would be the bracha to the land. And that is the question they asked over here. Which means, the Torah says that Enei Hashem Elokecha Ba, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has his eyes constantly on Eretz Israel. And Rashi explains, what does it mean that he has his eyes on Eretz Israel? He provides Eretz Israel. What does that mean? He provides every land in the world. You think other lands in the world are not provided by Hashem? Who they provided by otherwise? Rather, it means, says Rashi, that he provides Eretz Israel first, and together with that, he gives everybody else. which means while you have the Shekhinah Kedosha in Eretz Yisrael, Eretz Yisrael is protected and Eretz Yisrael is flourishing. It's a beautiful place because the Hashem is there, and with that everybody else is getting as well. But what happened over here was that nothing of that continued. It was be completely deserted. And the reason for that is because Hashem left the land. And once Hashem leaves the land, that's the most painful part of all. Because when Am Yisrael leaves the land, that's one thing. And you go to exile, maybe you come back like we came back right now. But when Hashem leaves the land, that becomes much harder to bring him back. And that is what we're waiting every day of the year, and especially on Tisha B'Av, although we came back to the land. But Hashem did not come back to his house yet. And Hashem is crying over that, says the Gemara in Chagiga Daf Hei. Hashem cries, he wants to come back. And that is the reason for the question over here, Al Mavda Aretz. Why was the land destroyed? Nitztakem Ibnam Iliover, where the place became so deserted? That is, Hashem says, the only reason for that is because once there's no Torah Lishma, I can't be here at all. For the sins, I'll destroy Bet HaMikdash. But if there's no Torah in a certain place, I can't be there. Hashem is not going to dwell in a place that they don't learn Torah. Once the people are not learning Torah over here, Hashem has to leave. And he has to go and look for a hotel. Mitneni b'midbar melon orchim, v'azva et ami. Question.